focusing on the future. It's the only way we're going to be able to build a new green infrastructure. Water systems, where no one in this country has to drink poison water.
Our administration is releasing the Biden-Harris Lead Pipe and Paint Action Plan to direct and coordinate the efforts of local, state, and federal partners to a single goal, to significantly accelerate the removal of lead pipes and paint over the next 10 years, particularly in communities that have historically been left out and left behind.
Vice President Kamala Harris yesterday unveiling a new plan to replace lead pipes and lead paint across the country, making good on a promise that Joe Biden made while announcing his campaign for president. And joining us now, U.S. Secretary of Labor Marty Walsh. Secretary, thank you very much for joining us. We keep hearing about the nation's crumbling infrastructure. When it comes to lead pipes and paint, just lay out how bad it is for us.
There's hundreds of thousands of pipes in our country that there's water going, drinking water going through, that's going into homes and schools all across America. And when you think 2021, almost 2022, we're still dealing with that issue, that needs to change. And the president laid that out when he was, as you mentioned a minute ago, when he was running for president. And quite honestly, all of his infrastructure bills, including what we'll talk about in a minute, truck driving, I'm sure, he talks about building a better America, and that means adding to the greatness of our country. That means supporting and building new roads and bridges. That means drinking water. That means broadband access. Throughout the pandemic, March of 2020, I was mayor of Boston, and we had to shut schools down. And we also had to send, when we send kids home with computers, we had to send them home with little hotspots so they could get on the Wi-Fi. So it is about the future of America, and there's really, it's absurd that people in our country and young people in our country are drinking water through lead pipes right now.
Yeah, it is absurd. The American Water Works Association estimates that the cost of replacing them all is more than $60 billion. President Biden asked for $45 billion from Congress to get it done, but as part of that bipartisan infrastructure bill, in the end, there's only $15 billion. It's a long way off, isn't it? The amount of money that's been designated is not going to do nearly enough to replace all of these pipes.
But some of this opportunity will cities and towns all across American states also have plans, and we just need to continue to collectively work together. This money is on top of what cities and towns have allocated. So I'll give an example. I was in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, about a month and a half ago. I was out there with Mayor Barrett, and he took me to a public works project, and what they were doing was replacing lead pipes in the city of Milwaukee, pipes that were connection into homes. So this is going to take an all-of-government investment, not just simply federal government investment, but many states and cities have already allotted or allocated money. This will help them as well get to that point.
Secretary Walsh, good morning. Jonathan Lemire, great to see you. Obviously, for your purposes, the bipartisan infrastructure bill was sort of the big piece of legislation you needed. But the Build Back Better Act also contains components that would, of course, fall under your purview, components that now are in real danger. I know the White House, the president put out a statement yesterday saying negotiations would continue, that they still hope to get this done. But I think we need to be clear here. It's uncertain whether or not the second part will finish through the Senate. How much do you need this to pass, and how negative would the consequences be if it doesn't?
Well, I'm still optimistic about the bill. I mean, when you think about the bill, which is not part of my purview, better child care, better care for adults and investments in those areas, investments in universal pre-kindergarten. I did that as mayor of Boston. For the Department of Labor, workforce development, job training, apprenticeships. I've gone around the country. I've talked to businesses. I've talked to tech companies. I've talked to all kinds of different companies, and they all need people. They all need people that are trained and educated. This bill, Build Back Better, would allow us the opportunity to move forward with our plans are. And our plans, quite honestly, are to work with businesses, to come up with public-private partnerships. It's not all public investment. There's going to be private investment about preparing the workforce of the future. When I say of the future, I'm talking next year and the year after, and creating pathways into the middle class. You know, there's a lot of conversation about people not going back to work or the great resignation, whatever you want to call it. Some people, honestly, you know, they're concerned about the virus, but some people are also concerned about the fact that they've been working in a job that they're not really, they're not getting any satisfaction out of. They're not creating a pathway for themselves into the middle class. And this, it would be a big mistake, in my opinion, if we didn't do Build Back Better, because the investment in it, it's an investment in people. Just like the investment in the bipartisan infrastructure law, we've never seen an investment like this in people, and the American people deserve an investment made in their future.
Okay, Secretary, talk about people getting back to work. The American Trucking Association has said that its sector is something like 80,000 drivers short. I know yesterday as well, the White House has a plan to try to get more truckers into the system, and with those supply chains all snarled up, Americans really need this urgently, and Lord knows we need it around the holiday time too. What can you do to get more people into trucking positions, but also to get them into trucking positions so that they are safe and the country is safe too?
Yeah, we had what I describe as a great meeting yesterday at the White House with independent truckers, with trucking companies, with advocates, and really sharing best practices. What we talked about yesterday was we're launching at the Department of Labor with the Department of Transportation, Secretary Buttigieg. It is the 90-day apprentice challenge. We're going to be working to get, in the next 90 days, companies signed up to get pre-apprenticeships for people into trucking. Right now, we have about 10,000 truckers or apprentices in a program for trucking. We want to you know, magnify that number or multiply that number in a big way. And I think we're going to see in the next 90 days is a lot more pathways. We also talked about challenges, CDL challenges and getting clearance, challenges at registry of motor vehicles around the country, challenges with getting recruiting people, challenges with age. Some of the product, some states have restrictions on nobody under 25 can drive certain trucks across state lines. We also have industries like gasoline that can't have drivers under the age of, I believe, 23. So we're working on all those challenges, removing those obstacles. There is a short-term plan, but there's also a long-term plan. We also heard yesterday from the trucking industries that, you know, 5-10 years ago, this was an industry that lots of people would go into and create a career out of it. And we've seen that go away to some degree. We need to reestablish that. There are lots of people in America that trucking, it would be a great job. Some people, they spoke yesterday of people starting at $70,000, earning as much as $161,000. So we have some work to do. And there's also a pathway. There was a woman there who runs the Trucking Association for representing women. 10% of all truckers are women. So we really need to, in the next 90 days, we have a lot of work to do to create better pathways into this program, including targeting our veterans. There are 250 roughly returning veterans every year. About 70,000 over the last 5 years have had CDL driver's licenses. These are great pathway jobs into the trucking industry. And we have to reestablish this industry as an industry that actually is an industry. And we're going to need it forever because, as was described yesterday, the products of the gallon of milk on the shelf at the supermarket, that was brought there by a truck. So this is not going away. So we have to reestablish and create better, good-paying jobs in this industry.
Okay, Secretary, if you could just get moving on that pretty fast, because Santa and his reindeers cannot do it all between now and Christmas, and kids are waiting for those stocking fillers.
Santa sent a message. Santa sent a message to the president that, you know, not to worry, kids. And then I think Santa's also given us a job here. He gives 90 days. He wants it cleared up by St. Patrick's Day, I think Santa wants it.
Okay. Labor Secretary Martin Walsh, thank you very much for joining us.
Hey, thanks so much for watching our YouTube channel. You can follow up on today's top stories and breaking news, or catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.